Hello and everyone, Sandy Caligiuri back at Whiteface Mountain and the World University Games Alpine Skiing Events. Today it's the men's giant slalom with a field of 95 skiers ready to descend onto the Thruway and Draper's Drop trails. We've had a weather change. The blue skies of the past two mornings have given way to some overnight rain. But thankfully that stopped about 90 minutes ago and now temps have started dropping. The racing surface is good and now it has a bit more grip. What remains to be seen, however, is how this will hold up as we get further into this very long field. Take a look at the first page of the start list. On the second page, the gold medal winner from the Alpine Combined, Albert Ortega. Oh. Jeremy Mathers, one of the Americans there, spoke with him prior to the race as he was getting ready to go to the lift, and he was enjoying the course. He knows there are a couple little tricky sections that have to be considered as you hope to come down as clean as possible, including a delay about five gates up from the finish, which at that point in the race, your legs are burning, the thighs are talking to you, and then you've got to ask your body to do maybe just a little bit more to bring a nice run down to the finish. There you see bib number one, Gianluca Bohm from Montana State University, and he will start this men's giant slalom. With a little more grip in the surface, is slightly softer. Some of the aggression may have to be relented, and you don't want to overturn, that's for sure. And of course, the skis have to be prepared accordingly. A few days ago, you probably wanted an edge that you could shave with. Today, perhaps a little bit less so. Bohm was ninth in the Super G at the beginning of the race period here on Whiteface Mountain. And here's that section with the delay built in just above the finish. Sharp turn there. You got to be careful going from the third to the last gate to the next to last gate. And he was able to get through. And his time is a minute 0.13 seconds. And now we're going to see how that stacks up.
Ball will be back at 12:30 local time, as you can see.
Not easy.
Just a good, smooth, solid run.
Our next skier is 23-year-old Jacob Dilling, sophomore from the University of Colorado. Dilling won his first NORAM race last month at Beaver Creek, a second team All-America in 2022. Dilling with a couple of good luck clicks of the poles. And he gets extolled out the gate. Just a sophomore at CU. Jacob Dilling. And he goes to the lead in the early going by 15 hundredths of a second over Gianluca Bohm. There's a delay there. Again, you don't want to get too anxious to start the next turn. Patience is a virtue on some of these sections. A little sideways there. He's still 11 hundredths up though. So he's got the skis running down the hill pretty good at this stage. Now he's going to get into a very tricky section here. A little side hill. And now he comes to the finish. And he's going to cross in a time. A minute 0.13. A flat-footed tie with Gianluca Bohm. This is our first look at Norway's Louis Fausa. He is from Oslo, from the University of Colorado. And he is another one of the attacking Vikings, we'll see, perhaps. He's 3/10 of a second plus ahead of the first two skiers, so yes. He is bringing it here down Whiteface Mountain as he gets ready to tackle the transition and then on to Draper's drop. Good turning above the gate. And now on to Draper's pitch. And let's see, after the delay, and that was good execution there. He crosses the line a quarter of a second up, time of 59.87, and Louis Fausa goes to the lead. Rebounding there a little bit wide out of that turn. But you know, it's so difficult to have the perfect, most precise run. Eric Weiler of Switzerland. A bronze in the Super G. So he already is going to leave Lake Placid and Whiteface Mountain with some hardware. He's 21 years of old from Brienz. His family owns a bed and breakfast in Brienz. He's 4/10 behind. Eric Weiler along the flatter part of this course. And his second intermediate time, he's only 17 hundredths out. Final half dozen gates of Draper's drop, a delay just to get their attention before the finish. And he's only 18 hundredths back. He goes to second place. Eric Weiler from Switzerland. Got the ski on a high edge. Not cutting as much snow, which may be indicating that he's being a bit lighter on the edge. In Switzerland, Federico Toscano. From the ski club at San Bernardino. Oh, he did not finish the Super G, and he's not going to finish the Giant Slalom. Got to the inside. Whether you're an elite level ski racer like Toscano, a recreational skier, going to the inside is never good. Switzerland's Andre Moser. An economics student, attends school at Thurn University. He's low there at the blue panel, made him low at the red. Fighting to get back online. Now can he make up a few fractions? He's less than half a second behind, which given the issues that he had up above, that's quite respectable that he was able to pull it back together. Moser was eighth in the Super G here over the weekend. Now he's only 400s behind, so he's gained a lot of time between the intermediate timing points.
Moser's got a good run going here. Make his way into the final three games.
Trying to put it all together, get it all the way down the hill, and his time will be a minute 0.11, a quarter of a second back in third place. That was a nice effort.
Third spot.
Italy's Luca Taranzano. He won the bronze in the Super G when we started racing here at Whiteface Mountain. 25 years of age, got the ski sideways. That's going to cost him. But if you're going to make a mistake, make it early. Have the steep in front of you, and hopefully he can use that momentum to come back into the picture. Yes, he did come back into the picture. He's a 10th of a second ahead. This is excellent skiing here after the bobble there. Very close to the start. Taranzano, second intermediate time. Wow, half a second ahead. Ah, no, he didn't do that. He had the lead staring him in the face. he was really turning on the Jets, and then right there through the panel and just couldn't get the skis around that gate. Attention, bib number 15, now on course, Jan Zabistran from the Czech Republic. A gold in the Super G, a bronze in the combined. Two-time Olympian, three-time World Championship team member. Outstanding skiing by Zabistran here, coming out of the start. Just last week, he was sixth in a Super G event at the Europa Cup race in Wengen, Switzerland. And let's see how he fares here as he enters Draper's Drop. A little side hill there that he negotiated. The delay poses no problem. Zabistran's time is good enough to go to first place by just a hundredth of a second. Jan Zabistran. Outstanding, and that makes him happy. Sure would.
A war here in run number two is getting prepared for us.
The first run now concluding. Jan Zabistran from the Czech Republic. 100th on top of Louis Fausa from Norway. Eric Weiler, the Swiss, is third, 1900s behind.
Defend with a 101.97.
Emil Karinen. Representing Finland, 23 years old. Over a second up right now. I don't know if Karinen is 6 seconds behind. I would be surprised if that's the case. Here is Karinen getting all the way home with a 6/10 of a second lead. Yeah, I had the feeling that 6 second disadvantage that flashed was dubious. And that was a terrific run. You could see it at the beginning. It was in a good flow. And he made it look pretty effortless, to be honest with you. Roman Frost. Trouble there at that blue gate. We have seen it more often than not in this run. Here's Hausman to the pitch. A delay right there. Okay, so far so good. Pretty clean there those last three, four gates, and he's 600s ahead. Yes, that was very good. Well executed by Roman Frost. We are now within the final 10. Back and forth they go here on the upper pitch. Hate to sound like a broken record, but that blue gate, that left-footed turn, has not treated many people kindly. Lagier half a second behind. almost lost his balance there. Just prior to the transition above Draper's drop.
Jeremy
Lagier, and he comes down a third of a second ahead. Jeremy Lagier just turned 25 a couple of days ago, and maybe a belated birthday present awaits him. Gustav Voello from Hemsedal, Norway. The University of Utah skier is off the course early in the second run. John Luca Bohm carries a good advantage out of the start. Looks like he got through the mousetrap up there. So I'm sure he's happy with that. Probably understood from course reports what was going on. John Luca Bohm a second ahead. But we're not going to say anything because we've seen people, for instance, Drukarov just a minute ago, looked like he was going to have a lead at the finish and didn't make it to the finish. Right there, look, and see, look at that. It is unbelievable. The last gate. I cannot believe this.
It is sliding through the finish line. Oh, my word, we're going to have to take a look at the replay. Did Bohm make the last gate? Did he slide across?
Hey, Jacob, go get it. Jacob Dilling wears bib number two. Now we got some weather coming in there. Breeze coming down the hill. And who knows, maybe that'll push him, give him a little advantage. Use Mother Nature's luck on his side. The blue gate again. So we have issues early in the run, and we have issues late in the run. Cost him a lot of time up there, over a second. But again, he made the mistake early, got the rest of the course to try to overcome it. It's like making a double bogey on the second hole. At least you got 16 more to try to wipe that out. On Draper's drop, Jacob Dilling. He won his first Nor-Am race last month at Beaver Creek, and he is in third at the moment.
2.97. That's good enough for third fastest for Jacob Dilling.
Andre Moser, 9/10 ahead, and Moser quickly goes off course.
Andre Moser. How about
Jeremy Lagier keeps occupying the golden chair right there. With four skiers left, will he still occupy? Will he still be there?
Louis Fausa and Jan
Eric Weiler of Switzerland. He won a silver medal here in the Super G. Three skiers left. Weiler leading by nearly a second. Okay, not perfect, but better than many. His lead is down to a quarter of a second. It'll be exciting now. the transition area here at the end of Thruway, and now Draper's drop. Do not blink in this final section. Through the delay. Okay, he's made it nicely and leads by a third of a second. Eric Weiler of Switzerland. And we now finally have a change at the top of the leader's box. Now the sharp end of the field is making it very interesting. Now Norway's Louis Fausa from Oslo. Little blow right there in the early going. That three-gate combo there didn't work well for him. And he's recovering, trying to keep his cool. Bit on the inside, a bit on the inside again, and now he's on the outside, looking in. There's the first inside move. Then he got the hip down on the inside. Opportunity for a medal, and it's gone. And here is Javistrand, leading by almost 2/10. Okay, not perfect coming out of the gate into those first few turns, but he continues on. Get to the timing point, he's a second up. The race right now is his. He's already won a gold and a bronze. Will he add to it? If so, what will it be? From the ski club, Chomutov, Zabistran leading by 1.4 seconds. He basically just has to ski nothing exceptional, just normal, and bring it home. Jan Zabistran, he is going to get the job done. Jan Zabistran winning by a second and a third. His second gold medal of these World University Games to go with the bronze. And the class of the field comes through once again. Wow. Jan Zabistran, he was up there observing everything that was going on, the problems, the DNFs, that experience counts for a lot. And he pulled himself together and then just had a very nice, solid, consistent run.
He's keeping an eye out for Saturday.
Final look, Zabistran, Weiler, Lagier. Jacob Dilling of the United States has been trending upward. He backed up a little bit and got a running start, and he almost hit the podium today, missed it by just a few fractions of a second.
Ladies and gentlemen, the late
there's the man of
Whiteface
Mountain
TCU World University
with
Games
two gold
winners.
And a bronze, Jan Zabistran. We thank you very much for joining us here at the World University Games Alpine Skiing Coverage. This is Sandy Caligiuri. We bid you so long from Whiteface Mountain near Lake Placid, New York, and the World University Games.